Now let me solve question number 6. And the question is, find the angle measure x in the following figure. So there are 4 figures given here, and in each figure there is unknown variable here x. So we need to find the value for x. Now at first let me do this A from question number 6. So this is the figure given in question number 6A. So this figure has 4 sides. So a polygon having 4 sides, we call it quadrilateral. And in quadrilateral, we know that the sum of angles of quadrilateral is 360 degree. So we can find the value for x here by using the angle sum property of a quadrilateral. Now here we add the 4 angles of a quadrilateral and equate to 360 degree. So first angle is 50 degree plus the second angle is 130 degree plus the third angle is 120 degree plus the fourth angle is x. And if we add all the 4 angles, then we get 360 degree. Now here in the left hand side, we add all the 3 angles, which gives 300 degree. And this plus x equals to, in the right hand side, we have 360 degree. Now we shift this 300 degree to the right, which gives x equals to 360 degree minus 300 degree. And after subtraction here, we get the value for x, which is 60 degree. So this is the answer for question number 6A. Now let me do question number 6C. So this is the given figure, and in this figure, the 3 angles are interior angle and the 2 angles are given here exterior angle. So interior angle, which lies within the polygon, but exterior angle, it lies outside the polygon. And this polygon has 5 sides, and a polygon having 5 sides, we call it pentagon. And in pentagon, if we add all the 5 interior angles, then we get 540 degree, which we have done earlier. Now we need to add all the 5 angles of this pentagon and equate to 540 degree in order to find the value for x. Now let us add all the 5 angles. The first angle is 30 degree plus the second angle here is x plus the third angle here is given only the exterior angle. So if the exterior angle is given, then we need to find the interior angle by subtracting it from 180 degree. So this third angle will be given by 180 degree minus 70 degree plus the fourth angle here is also not given directly. Exterior angle is given, which is 60 degree. So in order to write the interior angle, we need to subtract 60 degree from 180 degree. So here we write 180 degree minus 60 degree plus this fifth angle is also x and equate to 540 degree. So if the interior angle is not given, then we need to subtract the exterior angle from 180 degree in order to get the interior angle. Now here in the next step, this 30 degree plus x plus 180 degree minus 70 degree is 110 degree, then plus 180 degree minus 60 degree is 120 degree, then plus x equals to 540 degree. Now we add these three angles, 30 degree plus 110 degree plus 120 degree, and we add this x and x, so that we will get 260 degree plus 2x equals to 540 degree. And we shift this 260 degree to the right hand side. 2x equals to 540 degree minus 260 degree, and after subtracting here we get 2x equals to 280 degree. Now we divide 280 degree by 2 and we will get the value for x after dividing, which is 140 degree. So the value for x that we have got here is 40 degree. So in this way we have to solve question number 6. Now let me do question number 7a, and the question is find x plus y plus z, and the figure is given. So in this figure, x, y and z are the three exterior angles given, and the two interior angles are also given, which are 90 degree and 30 degree. Now our first task is to find the third interior angle. So let us first represent the third interior angle by A. And here the polygon is having three sides, so we call it triangle. And in order to find the value for A, we need to use the angle sum property of a triangle. And we know that the sum of all angles of a triangle is 180 degree. And we write 90 degree plus 30 degree plus A equals to 180 degree. Then we add 90 degree with 30 degree and we shift to the right side. Then it will be A equals to 180 degree minus 120 degree. Then after subtracting, the value for A is 60 degree. So we have got the value for third angle also, which is 60 degree. Now here we use the linear pair to find the value of x, y and z. Now to find the value for x, we can see here clearly that the 90 degree and x altogether is a linear pair. So when we add these two angles, we will get 180 degree. So from this we get the value for x, which is 180 degree minus 90 degree, which is 90 degree. So let this be our equation number 1. Then similarly we find the value for z. The angle z and angle 30 degree is a linear pair. So when we add z with 30 degree, we get 180 degree. So from this relation we get the value for z, which is 180 degree minus 30 degree, which will be 150 degree. So this is our equation number 2. And similarly we find the value for y, and here the angle A and angle Y, they are linear pair. And after putting the value of A, which we have obtained here 60 degree, we get the value for Y, which is 120 degree. So this is our equation number 3. So we have got the value for X, which is 90 degree, value for Y is 120 degree, and value for Z, which is 150 degree. Now we need to find x plus y plus z. So we add all the three equations. Now adding equation number 1, 2 and 3, we get x plus y plus z equals to 90 degree plus 120 degree plus 150 degree. After addition we will get 360 degree. So this is the answer for the 7a. Let me solve question number 7b. So where we need to find the value for x plus y plus z plus w. And this is the given figure. And in this figure, x, y, z and w are the four exterior angles given. And the three interior angles is also given, which are 60 degree, 80 degree and 120 degree. So among the four interior angle, three is given and one we need to find out. So let us represent the fourth interior angle by A. And here the polygon has four sides, so it belongs to quadrilateral, and we use the angle sum of a quadrilateral. The sum of all angles of quadrilateral is 360 degree. This we already know that. And we need to add all the four interior angles and equate to 360 degree. So here after addition, 60 degree, 120 degree and 80 degree, we need to shift to the right hand side, and it will be A equals to 360 degree minus 260 degree, and after subtraction we get A equals to 100 degree. So now we have got the value for the fourth interior angle. Then we use the concept of linear pair. This x and 120 degree are linear pair. So x plus 120 degree equals to 180 degree. So from here we get the value for x, which is 60 degree. So let this be our equation number 1. And similarly, the angle y and 80 degree are linear pair. So from there we get the value for y, which is 100 degree. So this is our equation number 2. And also the angle z and 60 degree are linear pair. So from there we get the value for z, which is 120 degree. So let this be our equation number 3. Now at last we need to find the value for w. The angle w and a, they are also linear pair. So we write w plus a equals to 180 degree, but we have got the value for a, which is 100 degree. So from there we get the value for w, which is 80 degree. So this is our fourth equation. Now what we have to do here is we have to add all the four equations. Adding equation number 1, 2, 3 and 4, we get x plus y plus z plus w equals to 60 degree plus 100 degree plus 120 degree plus 80 degree. So after simplifying on the right hand side, we get the value for x plus y plus z plus w, which is 360 degree. So this is the answer for question number 7b.